Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Biology Reader. Today in this session I will be discussing one of the most important topic of biochemistry, that is Watson and Crick model of DNA. So friends, let's get started. Watson and Crick model provides the best way to demonstrate the structure of DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. DNA is a complex organic biomolecule which functions as a carrier of genetic information that passes specific genes of a parent cell to the daughter cells from one generation to the next generation. DNA is formed by the combination of nitrogenous bases, sugar and phosphate groups. The eukaryotic cells possess DNA compactly packed within the structure that is called nucleus. The other membranous structures like mitochondria and chloroplast also possesses some content of the DNA. Whereas a prokaryotic cell lacks a specialized nucleus and the DNA or the genetic material is found within the cytosol. Let us discuss the structure of the DNA that was given by the scientists Watson and Crick. Watson and Crick displayed the structure of DNA after studying the manuscript of the two scientists Linus Pauling and Corey. Linus and Corey demonstrated a 3D structure of the nucleic acid which doesn't gain much attention. Then in early 1953, Watson and Crick studied the physical and chemical properties of the DNA and proposed a double helical model of the DNA, which is sometimes called semi-conservative model, in which two daughter molecules conserve one parental or old strand and one new strand. According to the Watson and Crick model, the strands of the DNA are coiled in such a way that the DNA appears like a twisted ladder. Let us look into this DNA structure. Here you could see two strands of the DNA that is having opposite polarity. The letters T, C, A and G stands for thymine, cytosine, adenine and guanine respectively, that complementarily pairs with the adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine. The sugar and the phosphate molecules hold the strands of the DNA. Friends, let us discuss the physical properties of the DNA. DNA exists as a double-stranded helix in which the two polynucleotide chains are helically twisted. The coiling of DNA is in a right-handed or clockwise direction. And both the strands of DNA run anti-parallel or in opposite directions, one in a 5' to 3' end and the other in a 3' to 5' end. The diameter of double-stranded DNA is generally 20 angstrom and the internuclear distance is 3.4 angstrom. In a single turn of DNA, 10 base pairs are present having a length of 34 angstrom. Coiling of DNA results in the formation of some wide indentations, what we call major grooves, and some narrow indentations, what we call minor grooves. These grooves function as a site of DNA binding proteins. Now coming into the chemical properties of the DNA. DNA contains four nitrogenous bases that are adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine. Adenine and guanine are the purine bases, having a single ring structure, whereas thymine and cytosine are the pyrimidine bases having a double ring structure. DNA follows a complementary base pairing rule and also obeys Chargaff's rule. In DNA, there is a complementary base pairing between the purine bases A and G with the pyrimidine bases T and C respectively. And according to the Chargaff's rule, the base composition of A plus T is not equal to the G plus C content, but the sum of purines, it means adenine and guanine, is equal to the number of pyrimidines, it means thymine and cytosine. The nitrogenous bases like adenine pairs with thymine via two hydrogen bonds and guanine pairs with cytosine via three hydrogen bonds. Deoxyribose sugar and phosphate group contributes to the backbone of DNA, which holds the strands of DNA together. The phosphodiester bond links the deoxyribonucleotides And the hydrogen bond links the nitrogenous bases, and this contributes to the DNA stability. Let us finish this video with the conclusion that the DNA is the largest or complex biomolecule which carries the genetic information of a person to build a new organism or a new life form. And to explain the structure of DNA, Watson and Crick proposed a DNA supermodel in the year 1953 that explains the DNA coiling, DNA stability, and the physicochemical properties of the DNA. So friends, this is all for today. To study this topic in detail, you may visit our official website, that is biologyreader.com. Link is provided in the description box. So friends, if you find this lesson useful, do like, comment, share, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon and stay tuned for more videos.